now joined courtside by Colonials associate head coach Charlie Biscaglia as Robert Morris defeats St. Francis University 57-43 here at the Sewell Center. And Charlie, strategy and execution got this game won for you guys.
Yeah, we came out with a lot of energy, you know, but what we sustained at the end was accountability on the most part defensively. We got to do a little bit better job in some bad areas there. We got to do a little better job of getting our hand up and contesting shots. But the work ethic was great today, and we held them well under their average. And I was proud of the defense. You know, the shots, we got off to a hot start, but the defense, you know, was a consistent effort, and that's what we pride ourselves on.
Before we talk offense, let's talk defense. Let's talk about some of the other superlatives in this basketball game. And I thought somebody that shone very brightly was Michaela Mulrain.
Yeah, Michaela did a great job today of catching the ball, wanting the ball, finishing strong at the basket. She was a great up and down player for us. She worked hard getting down the floor, and she defended well. I thought she did a great job on both ends. It was a very good game. It was a shame that she picked up that third the way she did. I told her, you know, that's a bad third foul, reaching around like that. You're really doing well, and I got to take you out now to protect you. And I wish that didn't happen, because she was really doing a great job for us.
9 points and nine rebounds, 1 point and one rebound away from a double-double for Michaela Mulrain. She had a heck of a basketball game. Let's talk about Megan Smith, who also didn't shine on the stat sheet, but when you saw her out there on the floor, she was doing things right.
Well, she had a really good game. I mean, sometimes, like you said, the stat sheet doesn't show what she did. She got doubled a lot down there, and she handled it a lot better. They did the same thing out at Loretto at PA, and she had trouble with that first time. This time, she stepped through well. She chinned the ball. She was composed. I thought she did a great job, again, of coming out and getting us started. She had a lot of early stuff for us, getting rebounds, putting back in. Yeah, she's done a good job now of elevating herself as a sophomore. Down the stretch, she's playing better. And hopefully that's a look of, you know, what we're going to get down from her going into the playoff game now.
Let's talk about both Ananiki Stamalampru and Ashley Ravelli, a couple of players that have had their struggles this season, but both players, the last couple times we've seen them, have played very, very well, both against LIU Brooklyn and here today.
Yeah, I was proud with Ashley because she's really under the weather, and she's really sick, and she's on medication, and she's working hard to be out there, and I'm really proud of her that she went out there today and she did what she did, controlling the game as much as she did. I mean, she got us into our offense. They threw a ton of junk at us. I mean, they didn't want to guard us man-to-man most of the game, because we've been doing a good job against man, and so they threw a lot of junk, and it confused us for a while, and it was good for us to see this, because I'd rather see it now than see it in the playoffs for the first time. So we'll go back to the film, but she did a great job on not turning the ball over and making sure she made good decisions, and she gutted it out. I mean, in the second half, you know, Janae Brown didn't have her best game. You know, she had three turnovers in 5 minutes. She needed to sit down today, and Ashley had to extend her minutes. She did a great job of that. I think she was one of the unsung heroes of the game, because of how much she had battled and stepped up and extended her minutes.
Rebecca Novato kind of quiet off the bench, but Jocelyn Jones filled that void nicely.
Yeah, Rebecca's got to understand that, you know, Stephen Curry hits that shot, but she's got to take it in a little bit more. You know, nobody's on you. Get in a little bit closer. She's a deadly three-point shooter, but she's shooting from too far out right now. That, you know, take a higher percentage. She's 50% from there when she's open, and she's got to step it in there. But, you know, she did a good job defensively today, too, of getting her hand on a lot of balls. And Jocelyn Jones has really improved. You know, she's really improved from last year to this year. She should be someone that they recognize as maybe the most improved player in this league because of how much now she comes to play more on a consistent basis and how she's finding herself. You know, I really wish she would have finished that right-hand drive with the end, you know, inside the last 4 minutes, because that was a real nice drive there. She just got to keep her head up at a lot of times and finish those baskets, but she's getting from A to B now.
57-43, Robert Morris defeating St. Francis University. With the win, the Colonials finish in third place in the Northeast Conference heading into the playoffs, and that makes it just a little bit more comfortable heading into the tournament, doesn't it?
Well, it could mean, you know, a home game in the second round if we do our job in the first round. That's what that can mean. And, you know, the way things were looking before these last three games, there was a question if we were going to be in the top four. And I'm the type of coach that I don't want to know anything. Don't give me scenarios. I don't want to know who's playing who and if they lose and this. I just want to know, let me know when we're not supposed to win. okay? And if we're not supposed to win, then tell me something, okay? But we have to go out there and play who's in front of us, and now we wind up in third. It was because of the focus. Those last three games, winning these last three, was all one game at a time and not worrying about anybody else. Worry about your own team, and then you'll climb the ladder, hopefully.
Well, we don't have the results yet of any of the other games, so we don't know who you'll play this upcoming Sunday, but we do know that it's 1 o'clock. Talk about the focus that the NEC tournament requires.
Well, you know, it's nice to be at home, but it doesn't guarantee anything. We used to play at 1 o'clock on Saturday, so it's a Sunday game at 1, so we should be used to the startup time and the regimen of going into a 1 o'clock game. But like I said, nothing's guaranteed because we're at home. Whoever we wind up playing, we have to make sure that we stay focused like we did these last three and know these teams inside and out and go into that game and say, don't worry about anything else in life when we get onto that court. And it's all going to be done in practice. Practice is by far the most important thing we do, by far. Nothing else comes close to practice. So they have to have a real good week of practice here. Players got to get healthy, and then whoever we play, we got to outwork them and earn the victory.
Well, I want to talk to you four more times this year, but it'll be the last time I talk to you as the associate head coach in the regular season. Talk about that.
Well, you know, it's I don't want to talk about the end because the end isn't here yet, but, these last games in the regular season, you know, I haven't even thought about it. You know what I mean? Because, you know, I've been doing this for so long with Coach Sale and in my role. So, you know, we're getting to that time now where I'm sweating a lot more during the games because I'm getting up a little bit more and, you know, the intensity's going up. So I really lost control of, you know, what's going on after this. And, you know, Coach Sale is going to give it his all. We're going to give it our all. And no matter what happens in the end, if we play hard, we're accountable, and we go out there as a team, no matter what happens, this is going to be a great season.
Let's talk about another win after the game on Sunday.
Well, yeah, of course. I mean, like I said, our goal is to go out there and do the best job we can, and hopefully that results in a win. And I'll tell you one thing. This week of practice, we're going to really focus, and we're going to make sure that we come out there and give it 100%.
Thanks a lot, Charlie.
Thank you, Adam.
Again, the final score, 57-43. Robert Morris defeats the St. Francis Red Flash. The Colonials finish third in the Northeast Conference as they head into the NEC tournament this upcoming Sunday, and we'll have the call for you right here on NEC Front Row. For Justin Piles, I'm Adam Guskey, and we'll talk to you then.